question is about Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. What does this Trinity actually represents?
Okay, the Hindu tradition is a very colorful tradition. And we are greedy. We like to think of God or the ultimate reality in a variety of different ways. Not that there are many different ultimate reality. The same ultimate reality can be pictured or polarized in different ways. This is the Hindu way. We love to think of this ultimate reality in a variety of different forms, different ways. Why? Suppose I'm a student. So I like to think of God as the one who gives me knowledge and education and music and dance. So I say, oh, I love Saraswati, white cloth with veena and all that. So we kind of have this habit of, in a way, looking at different facets of the ultimate reality because it, in a way, appeals to our characteristics, our own ambitions. So in the same way, for example, in the Vaishnava tradition, they said, okay, now let's make Vishnu the main God. So the Vaishnavites will believe that Vishnu is the central God and there are other helpers. So that's okay, Vishnu told Brahma, come on, create. So Brahma is there to create the universe. Then Vishnu said, look, I am such a lovely chap, I can destroy. So Shiva is your job, you destroy. Mm-hmm. So in a way, the Vaishnava tradition has produced this idea of Trimurti. Vishnu saying to Brahma, create, and Brahma creates, and then says, Shiva, you destroy, and Shiva destroys. Now, if you're a Shiva devotee, surely you don't like that. You don't like your particular Godhead to be given this kind of very ugly role of destroying the universe. So the Shiva tradition will not agree with that. And it's good for them, they shouldn't agree with that. So they immediately put the image of Nataraj, Lord of the Dance. And you can see straight away here, the image straight away shows Shiva in the role of creator. He's all this damru, sound which creates the universe. In one hand he's holding fire, symbol of destruction. In the third hand he's giving boons, preservation. So in this image of Nataraj, you can already see the idea of God as creator, preserver and destroyer. So different traditions, the Vaishnava tradition like to think of Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva doing different activity, and the Shaiva tradition said, no, we don't need others, only Shiva will do everything. So it is, if you like, human way of trying to relate to the idea of spirituality, and in a way invoking different aspirations regarding, you must think of God like the creator person or like the preserver person, and then giving this particular format to the deity they choose, Vishnu, Brahma, Shiva, whatever. Now be careful. We are a very majestic tradition. We allow this variation to coexist. We never say one is right, the Shaiva tradition is right, the Vishnu tradition. We don't do that. We will learn the trick of pluralism. The Vaishnava like to think like this. Look, let me also tidy up. There are six Puranas devoted to Brahma, six Puranas devoted to Vishnu, six Puranas devoted to Shiva. Now in the Shiva Puran, you'll find that Vishnu gets into trouble and Shiva sorts him out. In the Vaishnava Purans, you'll find that Shiva is always getting into trouble, he's lost his keys, and Vishnu said, no problem, I'll sort you out. This is standard practice. We are trying to, in a way, promote our own deity, our own Godhead, to a greater extent. We smile and we carry on. We know that neither, they're both colorful storytelling, and neither is literally true. So you can't say Brahma is superior, Vishnu is superior. This is the way you like to aspire to the idea of spirituality, and so be it.